Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. Today I'll be sharing 7 habits that have helped me bring a bit more productivity into my life. These are all pretty simple, so they can easily be incorporated into your life even if it's already pretty busy. Of course, not all habits work for everyone, but the ones that I'll be sharing have been beneficial for me, so I hope at least some of them can help you too. I hope you enjoyed this video and let us just get started with the habits. This first habit is something that I've been doing every day for a long time and that I have talked about in other videos, but it is simply to make a to-do list every morning. I've also gotten into the habit of color coding my list, so I use separate colors for academic tasks, work, and personal tasks. This shouldn't take more than about 5 minutes, and it is so helpful in the way that you always know what needs to be done. You don't have to spend unnecessary time figuring out what to do next, and you know when you can just relax for the rest of the day and not feel guilty about it. Another thing I try to do every morning is to set one or more goals for the day. Your goals don't have to be big, but I just find that it's easier to be productive when you're working towards a specific goal. You could also set goals that challenge you to be productive, like only using your phone for a total of 1 hour or less, or catching up or getting ahead in a specific class. Either way, setting goals is the first step on the way to achieving them, so I always give myself something that I can work towards that I can keep in mind throughout the day. Since starting university about a month ago, another habit that I've gotten into is to listen to an audiobook while commuting. A lot of us spend a bit of time every morning and afternoon traveling to and from work or school, and I've found that listening to an audiobook is a great way to make the most out of that time. You'll learn something new, hopefully either wake up or unwind for a bit, and you won't just be mindlessly scrolling through your Instagram feed. For the last few months, I've been using Audible to listen to audiobooks. If you're unfamiliar with Audible, it is an app that lets you download and listen to audiobooks of all different genres. At the moment, I'm listening to When Breath Becomes Air by Paul Kalanithi. As I've just started my own education within the medical field, it's so interesting to hear about other people's experiences, and Paul's story is a beautiful but heartbreaking one, and definitely one you can learn a lot from. I've partnered up with Audible to give all of you guys a 30-day free trial of Audible. To sign up, you can go to audible.com/studytee, or you can text studytee to 500500 if you're from the US. Audible has recently expanded their already pretty amazing selection of audiobooks by launching Audible Originals, which is an exclusive selection of famous works of literature, actual plays being performed, and many other audio titles by storytellers of several genres. If you decide to try out Audible, you get an audiobook of your choice and also 2 from the Audible Original section. I'm pretty sure that I'll be listening to one of those next, and at the moment, I'm highly considering either Murder on the Orient Express or Northanger Abbey. But no matter if you'd like to listen to science fiction, educational books, self-help books, or anything else, Audible has got it. Once you've downloaded an audiobook, it is yours to keep, and you can listen to it offline, which comes in very handy as I don't always have an internet connection while commuting. Again, if you would like to sign up for a 30-day free trial of Audible and get a total of 3 audiobooks of your choice, you can go to audible.com/studytee, or any viewers from the US can text studytee to 500500. I would highly recommend trying out Audible to make your time spent traveling a bit more productive. The next habit is something I should have started doing a long time ago, but I've finally started to try to read the news every day. Taking 5 to 10 minutes to read the news every morning and afternoon is the best way of finding out what's going on in the world and in your local area, making it a lot easier and more rewarding to take part in conversations and discussions, and you're guaranteed to learn something new. The best thing would of course be to read an actual newspaper as you'll avoid distractions, but not everyone has one available, so what works best for me and other students I've talked to is using a news app. Download an app that gives you a summary of the headlines every day, and it will be so much easier and faster to stay updated on current events. I also make it a habit to check one or two news websites every day. I prefer the New York Times for world news, and I also check a Norwegian news website. Another habit is something I've talked about in previous videos, but this has helped me so much, so I wanted to include it, and that is to do some type of brain training activity before you start studying or working for the day. You probably already know by now how much I love Sudoku puzzles, and I always have a book around to do a puzzle before I start studying. I feel like by doing a Sudoku, a crossword, or any other type of puzzle, I kind of get into a problem-solving mood, and it also makes it easier to focus afterwards. You could also get a brain training app, but the best ones do cost money, so you should consider if it's necessary before buying one. I just complete a Sudoku puzzle or a crossword every day. It works for me, and you can find the puzzles for free online. The next habit is to try and learn something new every day. I don't mean learning a new skill or anything, just taking some time every day to do something educational that is not related to school or work. Examples could be buying an educational book that interests you and reading a chapter or just a few pages. You could watch an educational YouTube video, as there are so many amazingly made videos out there, with some of my favorite channels being Kurzgesagt, Crash Course, and Life Noggin. Or you could simply come up with something you're wondering about and research it. Most of us probably spend a bit too much time on Netflix, social media, and so on every day, so it is pretty easy to spend around 15 minutes less doing that, and instead taking some time to learn something new. The final habit I'll be talking about is journaling. I've been doing this for a long time, and just taking a few minutes to journal every day has been so beneficial for me. I usually journal before bed, and it's a great way to do something non-screen related to unwind before I go to sleep. I am also able to remember my days better, and it's also a great way to reflect on my thoughts and kind of just get them down on the paper so that they bother me a bit less. If you find regular journaling to be boring or time-consuming, a good option is getting a 5-year journal. I've been writing in mine every night for over a year now, and you just write down one or a few sentences every day. You could, for example, write about an accomplishment, a world event that happened, something you experienced, something you learned, a happy memory, or anything else. Journaling is just a great way of remembering and reflecting, and a habit that I'm very glad I've included into my nightly routine. So these are 7 habits that hopefully can make your life a bit more productive. I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you have any habits of your own that you'd like to share, then please feel free to do so in the comment section. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you soon with another video.